George Wolkow has always been the biggest kid in school.
If you look at like photos of me, maybe in like elementary school, I was always kind of be, you know, head above everybody. But I'd say graduated middle school, probably around like 6'4", 6'5".
Now a hulking 6'7", 239 pounds, the 17-year-old out of Downers Grove North is ready to play with guys more his own size after the White Sox selected him in the 7th round of the Major League Baseball draft.
I knew that there was always a chance because I saw they're taking some college guys, so maybe they had a chance to save some money. And then kind of finally got that call, and his dream come true.
There were two notes in the makeup that were really important. We do a makeup profile on the player that their scout is required to dive into, like the dynamic of who the kid is. Two words, kind and confident. Kind and confident were big words in terms of his profile, because comprehension learning curve means you're kind or you care about others, so you're going to listen. All right. Number two, confidence. The supreme being in our game is confidence.
Wolkow decided to follow in the footsteps of his favorite player growing up, Bryce Harper, putting in extra work to graduate early and reclassify.
Almost like modeling some of what I did kind of like after him, like going and playing in the Northwoods and challenging myself with Power 5, D1 players, as well as, kind of being able to make that jump a year early. Overall, I was able to fill in all my credits in just the one school year. I took two English classes, and then I opted for a financial literacy course out of school, kind of like an online self-paced class to complete my NCAA requirements, just so I can have my 8th period free for baseball this year.
And even though he slipped to the 7th, the left-handed hitter prides himself on his athleticism and ability to hit the ball a long way.
You know, I've got the best raw power in the draft. I'll hit a ball farther or harder than anybody. I think being able to do that at 17, it's just the start.
Size, yeah, it's crazy. I mean, Nate is a big man. He was a defensive tackle at Western Michigan as a football player. So you think about the body size Nate had, when you get those genetics from your father. And they talk about that MLB combine. We were watching. We had a suite up above at Chase Field. We were watching him take BP and throw. And just to see him unlock these tools on that major league field, we were up there going, oh, boy.
Wolkow says he wasn't strictly Sox or Cubs growing up, but a Chicago fan. Still, to play one day at Guaranteed Rate Field just 20 miles from where he grew up would be something special.
That would mean the world to me. That'd be an unreal experience, unreal feeling, but really kind of be a blessing, be a great opportunity to be able to do so. To be able to go out and help a team that I grew up, watching, grew up loving, and kind of have that opportunity to go out and make an impact and kind of bring the White Sox home that World Series.
This is our fan base. These are the people that sit in our backyard. We care about our fans. We care about the prospects that lie in this state, to land both these guys, to put them in White Sox uniforms, for White Sox fans to be a part of the culture. We feel fortunate.
As for individual goals, Wolkow is aiming for heights to match his 6'7 frame.
You know, my goal is to be a Hall of Famer. I think that it's an individual goal and one that I'll set very high for myself. But, I feel like I could be a leader on the field. And so for me, the goal is to bring home Chicago White Sox a World Series. And by doing that, I think for me, it's kind of going out every day and just trying to be the best version of myself. The sooner I can do that, the better.
I mean, let's just give the kid the credit for having the confidence to say that, or having the driven goal at 17 years old to know where he's trying to do, okay? So I think most people would never say that because that's risky, all right? So when we evaluate these kids today, we almost look at them like, how much risk is the player willing to take? Think about the risk George is taking. I don't know. I'm going to graduate high school early. I'm going to bypass South Carolina. All right, the SEC school where I could really make myself a formidable prospect in 3 years. And number three, I'm going to jump into the greatest challenge I'm ever going to face as a human being and be a professional athlete. That's what I think most people look at. Oh, he got drafted. Well, remember, these players are the best players in the world he's going to go compete against, and he's got to climb this challenge. We believe in the kid. We believe in the family dynamic, most importantly, how he's been raised. I think that's the most unique part about George.
Josh Friedman, WGN News.